The title of my message is Be Holy Because I am Holy. Let's read verse 45. Shall we go? I am the Lord who brought you up out of Egypt to be your God. Therefore be holy because I am holy. Okay, out of your memory. Can you say it together, please? I am the Lord who brought you out of Egypt to be your God. Therefore be holy because I am holy. We studied up to chapter 10, chapters 1 through 11 are related to the altar on which the offerings were sacrificed for sinners to come to God. Chapters 11 through 15 are related to people's practical life. Particularly chapter 11 is about eating, what to eat and not eat. God gave them a clear diet law with detailed regulations so they might know who they are. Through daily matter of eating, God wants them to be reminded of their identity as the holy people of God. Whenever they ate, they'll know their identity, belonging to the Lord, who brought them out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. So what a wisdom of God. Whenever they ate, they would remember their identity. Of course, all the details, laws here, dietary laws, are not relevant to us. However, the speed of this chapter with 47 verses is certainly applicable to us. It seems that in our time, many Christians are not aware of their identity. Their spirit just mingles with the spirit of this world. However, daily remembrance of our identity affects our life, daily life. So may God help us to go deep into the spirit of this chapter, Leviticus chapter 11. This chapter begins with the words, "The Lord said to Moses and Aaron." Now, God recognizes Aaron as the high priest, recognizes his authority to speak both to Moses and Aaron. In verse 1 through 23, the Lord specified what they were to eat and not to eat, concerning land animals, and then the living creatures in the seas and streams, and birds and flying insects. Here, verse 23, the Lord said, "Say to Israelites, of all the animals that live on land, these are the ones you may eat. You may eat an animal that has split hoof completely divided, and then choose the cord, and that of the least, camel, the coney, the rabbit. They cut, they chew the cord, but do not have a split hoof. But pig has a split hoof, completely divided, but does not chew the cord." The reason is, in each case, it is unclean for you. We don't know why they are unclean, but God said, it's unclean for you. Probably, the Egyptians ate all such unclean food freely. While they were in Egypt, they were just hungry, consumed any food before them. They were slaves there. In the desert, God rained down manna from heaven. But when they entered the promised land, they did not just follow their eating style of Canaanites. They were to follow God's dietary laws, knowing that they were different, set apart for God. In Deuteronomy chapter 14, it says, "Do not eat any detestable thing. These are the animals you may eat: the ox, the sheep, the goat, the deer, the gazelle, the roe deer, the wild goat, the ibex, the antelope, the mountain sheep." The ibex is kind of wild goat, antelope kind of deer. 10 names of animals they can eat. It seems that God allows them to eat gentle, grass-feeding animals, but not the animals that consumes, devours food as predators. Here God specified, gave regulations about the food later on in chapters 18 through 20 about sex. The point is that they should not follow the custom of the world. And they should not eat their meat, that's the carcasses in verse 8. But carcasses, you will think about it, you think about it later. So about land animals, they ought to eat or not to eat. And among the living creatures in the seas and streams, they ought to eat those have fins and scales. It's written three times. Those who have fins and scales, you can eat. If they do not have fins and scales, no. Fins and scales, they can swim. Even swim against the flow. Fins and scales, fresh and strong. But just stay there, maybe like lobsters or octopus or shrimp. Do you like those food? But at that time, now it's okay. Jesus declared all food are clean. But at that time, those have fish and have fins and scales can eat. And then birds. Here, these are the birds you have to detest, not eat because they are detestable. List from beginning with eagle. Eagle. To bat. See? Eagle. And vulture, black vulture, red kite, black kite, raven, horned owl, switched owl, gull, hawk, little owl, cormorant, great owl, white owl, desert owl, osprey, stork, heron, hoopoe, bat. John, you know all these birds? Six owls, wow. Horned owl, switch owl, little owl, great owl, white owl, desert owl. I know some of you like owls. God said in Psalm 20, 50, I know every bird in the mountain. Wow, just 20. When you think about, I think about this list, God really is very delicate that his people, he does not want these people to be defiled or become unclean and by any of these. And Jesus said, the very numbers of you, the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Oh God, delicate God, delicately caring. And among the insects, flying insects, they have four legs. They walk on four legs. You are not to eat, but some of them you can eat here. Those have joint legs for hopping on the ground. Jonathan, do you have joint legs? You have with knees, jump. Those have joint legs. Hopping ground, on the ground, you can. Here, locust, katydid, cricket, grasshoppers. Similar. It's interesting. Have jointed legs for hopping on the ground. In NASB, have jointed legs above their feet, with which jump on the earth. Christians are not those who just walk on the ground, but is to the earth only. They jump on the ground toward heaven, higher ground. As you sing, higher ground. How about this part? Let's sing together. Lord, lift me up. Okay, shall we go? Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven's table land. A higher plane than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Jump on the earth to head it toward higher ground. Whenever we feel these difficulties, this when you feel dejected, depressed, jump on the earth toward heaven. You can eat those flying insects. Joint legs above their feet. It's a jump on the earth. And verse 24 says, you'll make yourselves unclean by this. Whoever touches their carcasses will be unclean till evening. Uncleanness comes from dead bodies. So don't eat carcasses, don't touch. Understandable. Death is the result of sin. And then this verse expression are repeated. Those move about the ground, move along the ground. 6 times. Remember Genesis chapter 3? Serpent that represents devil and Satan that tempted Adam. Serpent was cursed. Throughout your life, you'll crawl on your belly. Yes. So, don't eat. But, and then listed are the names. Beginning with the whistle. 8 names are here. Whistle, rat, great lizard, gecko, monitor, lizard, wall lizard, skink, chameleon, has highly developed ability to change colors. See, 3 lizard, great lizard, monitor lizard, wall lizard. We really feel that, why toys? Now the children toys are like, have this kind of weird images. Eh? Why? Really, devil's work is strategic, rampant. In their young mind, these images remain there. But parents really should be step discernment and raise them differently. Not such images. Anyway, don't eat. It's the hill. And then it says, spring, however, or a cistern for collecting water remain clean. A lot of water cannot be contaminated. And there's a difference between dry seed, carcass falls on it. By it's planted, uncleanness can be observed. Uncleanness can be observed on the ground. But wet seed, different. But God's point is God is specific and delicate. Then let's read verse 44. Shall we go? I am the Lord your God. Consecrate yourselves and be holy because I am holy. We learned that the sprinkling of the blood, anointing of oil, consecrated the priests, the altar, and the tabernacle. Right? Sprinkle blood, anointing of oil, sanctify them, consecrate them. But here, life according to the word of the Lord. That life, such practical life, consecrates us. Jesus said, My mother and brothers are those who hear God's word and put them into practice. And Paul said, Whatever you learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice. It's again our life in obedience to the word of God consecrates us. And then let's read verse 45. I'm the Lord who brought you up out of Egypt. Together, please. I'm the Lord who brought you up out of Egypt to be your God. Therefore, be holy because I'm holy. What an expression. Ten commandments start with this verse. I'm the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. Their relationship with the Lord began with this. When God delivered them out of the land of slavery, they became his people. The Lord became their God. They had been slaves. They were slaves in Egypt for 430 years, long lasting years. No power would liberate them. But the Lord brought them out of Egypt, land of slavery. He's a God of salvation. Lord is the God of salvation. He's holy. If you receive that grace, be holy. And how can we eat here? Knowing what can be eaten, not eaten. Through daily matter of eating, they may know their identity and remain and live as a holy people of God and be holy. As for us, thank and praise God. Thank and praise God for Christ Jesus, who redeemed us from all the bondage of sin and death, evil spirits, and eternal condemnation. He redeemed us through his precious blood and made us holy. If you receive that grace, what a people of God they are. And Peter also said, be holy. Again, how can this passage apply to us? Yes, Jesus declared all food clean. And in Acts chapter 10, a voice came from heaven. And a voice said to Peter, do not call anything impure that God has made clean. And 1 Timothy chapter 4, Paul said, everything God created is good. It's not to be rejected if it's received with thanksgiving. It's consecrated by the word of God and prayer. Enjoy all food, good, thanksgiving. When you think about our times, people seem to be obsessed by food and sex. To enjoy their life to maximum degree. Eat, love, live seems to be slogan of the people of our time. How to enjoy delicious food? It seems to be a primary concern. Their stomach become their God, as Paul said. But those who receive the grace of Jesus, redeemed people should be different. They should jump from this trend of the world. Purpose of eating should be different. Eat for the glory of the Lord. Different. Yes, we can eat among family members together. Eating together means having close relationship. Joyfully and thankfully, family members can eat together, God's people gather together and eat. And also with contentment. Whatever food is given, contentment. But also, we should be considerate of others. If my eating causes our brothers to fall, then I'll not eat meat. If my eating causes others to fall, that's wrong. What a decision, I love it, meat. He valued brother's faith more than his own appetite. And God's people should not just mingle with the people of the world and eat with them. Except the evangelical purpose. As Levi invited all his old friends, tax collectors, and new friends, Jesus' disciples, that they may have a chance to experience Jesus. In that case, yes, evangelical purpose can eat, but just mingle with the people of the world, eat with them, no, knowing their identity. And Jesus also said, when you invite the needy people, so you may be repaid as time of resurrection. We are living in the time of giving and taking. You invited one time, so I'll invite you back one time. That's not necessarily bad, but Jesus wants us to have a genuine invitation in the name of the Lord Jesus. In this study, most importantly, whenever we eat, we may know who we are, redeemed, by Christ Jesus and made holy who we are whenever we eat and through daily practice of eating. Daily matter of eating, he wants us to remember our identity and then be made holy, different from the people of the world. Purpose of eating is different. And also, manner of eating is different. Mindful for others. When husband and wife eat together, honey, you may eat delicious food more. You may eat. When parents and children eat, Eunice, Daniela, Jonathan, when you eat with the parents, hi mommy, hi daddy, this is very delicious. You eat it first. You eat it first. Then, in that way, you if honor God, if you honor your parents in eating, you'll be blessed. Yeah. Jonathan, delicious food before you're eating, parents. And we might be mindful. Okay, purpose of eating, manner of eating, different. Our God, God desires that His holiness may permeate into the lives of His people through their daily manner of eating done in obedience to the word of God. Finally, remember that Jesus said, my flesh is my real food. My blood is my real drink. May we feed on Jesus daily that can truly make us holy. Amen. Let's pray. Dear Father, thank you very much for your study. This beautiful chapter, Leviticus chapter 11. Father, this is the word of God. I'm the Lord your God. I'm the Lord who brought you out of Egypt to be your God. Be holy because I'm holy. We see God's eager desire to help their people. Eagerly desire that His people may know who they are. Liberated from the bondage of Egypt. And holy because the Lord is holy. We thank and praise you for the redemption in Jesus Christ. Christ redeemed us from all the bondage of sin and death, evil spirits, eternal condemnation through His precious blood. We are this people of God and made holy. Father, we see how people eat. It's not their primary concern, but God's people should be different, knowing who we are at each time to eat. We may have daily manner of eating in accordance with the word of God and live as your people, different, set apart for your purpose in this world. Thank you for your words. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.